हम बात सलाम पेश करें। बारे दीगर सलवात
पुकारि ज़ैनब मुज़्तर, पुकारि ज़ैनब मुज़्तर, हुसैन आ जाओ। पुकारि ज़ैनब मुज़्तर, हुसैन आ जाओ। जो तुम नहीं तो नहीं कोई पूछने वाला, जो तुम नहीं तो नहीं कोई पूछने वाला। दिलों पे चलते हैं खंजर, दिलों पे चलते हैं खंजर, हुसैन आ जाओ। नहीं है ताब सकी नाम अब तमाचों की, नहीं है ताब सकी नाम अब तमाचों की। सुला लो सीने पे आकर हुसैन आ जाओ। वो नन्हे हाथों में दामन फटा हुआ लेकर, वो नन्हे हाथों में दामन फटा हुआ लेकर, सकीना कहती है रोकर हुसैन आ जाओ। तुम्हारे बाद ये तौकीर हो गई भैया, तुम्हारे बाद ये तौकीर हो गई भैया। सरों से छिन गई चादर, सरों से छिन गई चादर, हुसैन आ जाओ। जो तुम नहीं तो वतन जाके क्या करूं भैया, जो तुम नहीं तो वतन जाके क्या करूं भैया। मैं फिर के आई हूँ दर दर, मैं फिर के आई हूँ दर दर, हुसैन आ जाओ। पुकारि ज़ैनब मुज़्तर, हुसैन आ जाओ।
जज़ाकअल्लाह। बस अब इल्तमास करूँगा बात समरसी पर शिकल है। बार दीगर सलवात सल्ले अला मुहम्मद व आल मुहम्मद।
सलवात
नाम पर शाह کے پانی جو پلا دیتے ہیں میرے کوثر مجھے دعا میرے کوثر مجھے دعا دیتے ہیں
قتل اکبر سب سر ہوتا ہے شے کرتے ہیں شکر
صبر ایوب کو شب دلاتے
صبر ایوب
کو شب دلاتے
پوچھتا ہے جو کوئی کس نے کمر کو توڑا
شاباس کے لاش کو دکھا
شاباس
کے لاش کو دکھا دے
نام پر پانی جو پلا دے جب صدر زی سے گر پڑے عباس باوفا جنگل سے آئی گریہ زہرا کی بھی صدا اکبر نے دوڑ کر شہ والا سے یہ کہا
چلیے حضور نہر پہ مارے گئے چچا
چلیے حضور نہر
پہ مارے گئے چچا
بے دست دشمنوں نے کیا اس دل کو
شیر کو
یہ سن کے پیٹتے ہوئے اٹھے زمین سے شاہ فرمایا ہے غضب میرے بچے ہوئے تباہ یہ کیا کہا کہ آنکھوں میں دن ہو گیا سیاہ
مظلوم سے بچھڑ گئے عباسا
مظلوم سے بچھڑ
گئے عباسا
مدت ہوئی تمام سکینہ کے چین کی
توڑا فلک نے آج کمر کو حسین کی
توڑا فلک
نے آج کمر کو حسین کی
کے خون بھرے ہوئے چہرے پدی صدا بھیا حسین آیا ہے آواز دو ذرا ہے ہاتھ دونوں ہاتھ بدن سے ہوئے جدا
بازو کے صدقے ان تیرے شانوں کے میں فدا
بازو کے صدقے
ان تیرے شانوں کے میں فدا
بھیا ہمارے ہاتھوں بیکار ہو گئے
تم ہاتھ ہو کے جعفر تیار ہو گئے
تم ہاتھ
ہو کے جعفر تیار ہو گئے
صدائے حضرت شبیر نامدار کھولا آنکھوں کو ایک بار سر رکھ کے پائے شاپے بولا وہ زیب خات تشریف آپ لائے
جہیز و اتفاق
تشریف آپ لائے جہیز و اتفاق جی چاہتا ہے یہ کہ نثار حضور ہو
کس طرح اٹھ کے گرد پھرو چور چور ہو
کس طرح اٹھ
کے گرد پھرو چور چور ہو
بخش دے گنا سر شخ ضرب گرز سے یا شاہ دی پناہ
کروٹ بھی اب تو لے نہیں سکتا ہے خیر خواہ
کروٹ بھی اب تو لے نہیں سکتا ہے خیر خواہ دکھتے ہیں بولنے میں جراحت پھٹے ہوئے
دیکھے حضور میرے بازو کٹے ہوئے
دیکھے حضور
میرے بازو کٹے ہوئے
لگے شاہ خوش خصال عباس میں کن آنکھوں سے دیکھوں تیرا یہ حال اس دم بھی ہے تمہیں میرے آداب کا خیال
جب زبا ہوں گے ہم تمہیں کسے
ہوئے گا ملا جب زبا ہوں گے ہم تو کسے ہوئے گا
ملا
صدقِ حسین تیرے تنے پاش پاش کے ایک بار ہم کو گرد
تو پھرنے دو لاش کے
ایک بار ہم کو گرد تو
پھرنے دو لاش کے
یہ سن کے اس دل نے ایک سرد آہ کی مشکی زپا تڑپ کے بصارت نگاہ کی مو شرم سے چھپا لیا گودی میں شاہ کی حالت
تباہ ہو گئی ہے در کے ماہ کی
حالت
تباہ ہو گئی ہے در کے ماہ کی
جب دل کو بے کلی ہو تو کس طرح کل پڑے
زانو پشے کے آنکھوں سے آنسو نکل پڑے
زانو پشے
کے آنکھوں سے آنسو نکل پڑے
یہ کہتے تھے کہ پھر گئی آنکھوں کی پتلیاں ہچکی کے ساتھ آ گئی سوکھے لبوں پجا حسرت سے دیکھ کر طرف شاہ انسو جا
دنیا سے کوچ کر گئے ابا سے نوجوان
دنیا سے کوچ کر گئے
ابا سے نوجوان
چھوڑا جرین ساتھ شہ مشرقین کا
ایک غل اٹھا کے مر گیا شیخ حسین کا
ایک غل اٹھا کے مر گیا شیخ حسین کا
بر محمد و آل محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم اللہ محمد Let us call on Sheikh Jaleel to address the majlis, please. Bare digar salawat.
Salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ali.
الحمد لله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدي وحبيبي ونور قلبي أبي القاسم محمد، اللهم صل وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين ذاب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. نسأل كويس في سورة الفاتحة المرحوم المغفور سيد نعيم حسين زيدي سان اوف سيد ممتاز حسين زيدي، مي الله بليس ويت هي سول، سورة المباركة الفاتحة. بسم الله. نوزو سورة المباركة الفاتحة يوم مرحومين المرحومات، مي الله بليس ويت اول اوف ذم، سورة الفاتحة. بسم الله. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. قال الله العلي العظيم في كتابه الكريم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، قالوا ربنا أمتنا اثنتين وأحييتنا اثنتين فاعترفنا بذنوبنا فهل إلى خروج من سبيل. صدق الله العلي العظيم. الله tonight our topic is one of our beliefs as a Shia school of thought. And it's very well known among the Shia school of thought as this belief is called Ar-Raj'a. Ar-Raj'a, with its definition, it has three different school of thought among the Muslim Ummah. Muslims divided into three when it comes to Ar-Raj'a. But before we talk about the three school of thought and what are the reasoning behind, what is the definition of Raj'a? Because Raj'a is one of the key points in the Shia school of thought. However, there are misunderstanding about what this Aqidah is about. When we say the word Ar-Raj'a in Arabic, literally meaning return. As we say in Arabic, Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raj'un. Ar-Raj'a, returning back to someone. That is called Ar-Raj'a, to return back to someone. That's called Ar-Raj'a. That's literally in Arabic. Now, istilahan, meaning how the Shia school of thought identify Ar-Raj'a is a different story. In the Shia school of thought, when they say Ar-Raj'a, they mean there are two group of people. Many people, they always think it's one group. No. There are two group of people. The first group are the good mu'mineen, who lived a good life and died on the path of Iman. Some of them, not all of them, some of those mu'mineen, after they die, go to the barzakh for years, Allah will return them back to this life. That's group number one. After they die, they will come back to this life. The second group are the people who are the worst people on this planet in terms of disbelief, in terms of oppression. The worst of them will also be given the chance to come back. Now, the point is here where people get misunderstanding. How are they going to come back? Are they going to come back being born again like they were born before? Or no, they will come back in different way. Some of the scholars believe that those people, when they come back, they will not be born like they were born before. They will be resurrected, coming back to this life from the grave. That is the understanding. So, ar-raj'a meaning people who live and die, they might be good, they might be bad. After death, for a certain period of time, which nobody knows except Allah, in his own wish, his own knowledge, he chooses them to come back to this life again, to give them another chance of life and then die again. And this is what we call ar-raj'a. This aqidah, as we just mentioned, there are three different opinions about it. Opinion number one is the opinion of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. They believe this is impossible. And this has no base in Islam. And they believe that anyone who believes in raj'a can be called a kafir. That's how extreme they go. Believing in raj'a can be a reason to identify someone as kafir. And in ilm al-hadith, ilm al-diraya, they've gone so far to the point, if a person believes in raj'a, it's enough not to take hadith from him. As they narrate hadith, if they come to know this person, he believes in raj'a, they reject him and they don't take hadith from him just because he believes in raj'a. That is how far they go. That is opinion number one. Opinion number two is the minority among the Shia who believe ar-raj'a, in the definition we mentioned, it's not real. It's not going to happen. They're Shia, but they believe ar-raj'a that Quran is talking is referring to what? To yawm al-qiyamah. You live in this world, you die, you go to barzakh, you live another life there, you get resurrected yawm al-qiyamah, and that's the raj'a. You're coming back yawm al-qiyamah, and that is the meaning of raj'a. But the raj'a meaning to come back to this world and live some years, they say this is not possible. That is the second school of thought among the Muslims. Number three, these are the majority of Shia who would believe ar-raj'a is a belief that certain people, after living and die, Allah will bring them back to this life, to live to a certain point of life before yawm al-qiyamah as well. That is the three school of thought. But now the question is, those who believe in ar-raj'a, according to the way we believe, what is their proof from the Quran? Do they have any reasoning from the Quran to back that belief, or they don't have any proof to back that belief as a Shia? And that is where the Shia school of thought, they came with the reasoning from the Quran to prove that raj'a is doable and is in the Quran as well. Now, if that is the case, what is the proof of the Shia, those who believe in this? Now, before we go further, brothers and sisters, our scholars who believe in Raj'ah in this sense, they said even if a Shia doesn't believe in it, it's still considered Shia. Meaning what? Meaning if I don't believe in Raj'ah in this line, doesn't make me less Shia. Why? Because believing in Raj'ah is not Usuluddin. Usuluddin is the key. So if a person says, I don't believe in Usuluddin, then they are not Muslims. The moment a person rejects one of Usuluddin, then the person becomes out of Islam. Or when the person rejects what we call daruratun min daruriyat al-deen, automatically becomes out of salah, out of Islam as well. For example, one of the key of Islam is believing in salat is wajib. If a person says, I don't believe salat is wajib, they become out of Islam. Even though it's not Usuluddin, but rejecting one of the basic teaching of Islam can put a person out of Islam. However, believing or not believing in Ar-Raj'ah wouldn't take one out of the Islam. However, it's one of the belief which strengthen one's aqidah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in that sense, those majority of our scholars, they believe that Ar-Raj'ah is one of the school of thought that we believe in as a Shia. Now, what is the wisdom behind it? Now, as you know, in the Shia school of thought, all our reasoning is always divided into two. One is called Dalil Aqli, one is called Dalil Naqli. Al-Aqli means the intellectual proof. The other one is called the Quran or Hadith al-Nabawi to prove the point. Now, why do Shia believe in Raj'ah? Because there are Dalil al-Naqli which they use to prove in what we call Ar-Raj'ah. Now, the first proof the Shia comes from the Quran, they said, is an ayah in Surah Ghafir. Al-Ghafir, in Quran, you know, some surahs have two names. Some surahs are given more than one name, and some surahs have two names, some only have one name. Now, Surah Ghafir has two names. Sometimes it's called Suratul Mu'min. So depending on the Quran that you read, sometimes it's referred to Surah Al-Mu'min and sometimes Surah Al-Ghafir. Now, this surah, ayah number 11, is where the Shia, through the hadith of Ahlul Bayt, they prove that yes, Ar-Raj'ah in this meaning exists in the Shia school of thought. What is it? The ayah says, Yawm Al-Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after people were given the opportunity of hisab and iqab, before sending them to heaven or sending them to hellfire, those who are now about to go to hellfire, they are the one, they will make this statement when they realize the severity of the punishment. Because you know, Yawm al-Qiyamah, things become real. And Quran says, oh, you servant of Allah, لَكَدْ كُنْتَ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٍ. Allah says, you servant of Allah, we told you about this life, we told you about the Qiyamah, about Barzakh, about heaven, about hell, but you never trusted it. Today, your eyes is to see it as real. When they see the fire and they realize how severe the fire is, then they make that statement in Surah Al-Ghafir. What did they say? Qal, Quran quote them. Rabbana, O our Lord, amattana ithnatayn, wa ahyaytana ithnatayn. O our Lord, you have given us life twice. Now, there are different tafsir according to the scholars. Some they say, amattana ithnatayn, the ayah is referring before we were created. We were like diseased. Then Allah created us. Then we die. Then we go to Yawm al-Qiyamah. So the first maut is the life before we got created. That's death. Now, then after we got created, we live the life and then we die. That's the second death that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about. That is one tafsir. Now, the second tafsir is enough. The first life that Allah is talking about is the life after we were born. Then after we die, we live another life in barzakh. Why? Because life in barzakh is life too. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتًا بَلْ أَحْيَاءً. That's it, they're living. Where? In barzakh. So when Allah says, أَمَتَّنَا اثْنَتَيْنِ وَأَحْيَيْتَنَا, it's referring to the life on this planet. One, two, حيات البرزخية, and then يوم القيامة. So the word أَحْيَيْتَنَا وَأَمَتَّنَا, that's the tafsir number two. Shia who believe the other way, they say no, the eye doesn't mean that way. Why? They say because when you look at the word amatana, cannot be referred to what? To the life before we got created. Why? Because in Arabic the word al-maut, what does it mean? Ay bima'na infisal ar-ruh an al-jasad. There is a life which consists of ruh and the badan together. Right? Now, when they separate, we call it what? Maut. Now, before Allah created us, there is no life there. There is no hayat where it's embodied and then they get separated. So that cannot be called what? Al-maut. So the word al-maut must be referred to a life which was given, and then the body and the ruh were together, and then they get separated. Then it's called al-maut. Because if you look in Arabic, the definition of maut, infisal ruh an al-jasad. Now, then he says, wa ahyaytana. Al-ihya is also the same. In Arabic, there is al-hayat, and then there is al-ihya. Al-ihya is to give life to something that lost life in the beginning. If something never had a life, you don't call it ihya, right? So when we say watuhyil mauta, and maut is a body which had a life and then lost it and then was given the life secondly, that is called ihya. So when the ayah says amattanathnatayn, oh Allah, you give us a life twice, it has to be this life that we live in. After we were created, we were given life to live on this planet. After we die and go to barzakh, which is called al-maut, then Allah gives another life to come back. When you get that life with the body again to come to this life and live for some time, that is called another hayat for the second time. Now, when you die, that is what you call the second death. And that is what the ayah is talking about. قَالُوا رَبَّنَا أَمَتَّنَا إِثْنَتَيْنِ. And if you look at the word إِحْيَا and إِمَاتَ, Allah didn't stop there. He added إِثْنَتَيْنِ, which means twice. So the ayah أَحْيَيْتَنَا وَأَمَتَّنَا إِثْنَتَيْنِ. Then he said, فَأَتَرَفْنَا بِذُنُوبِنَا, and we confess our sins in this world. فَهَلْ مِنْ خُرُوجٍ أَفَهَلْ إِلَىٰ خُرُوجٍ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. Ya Allah, is there any way out you can get us out of this hellfire? So that ayah is one of the proof of what we call الرَّجَعَ in Islam. That is number one. Number two, the same scholars believe there are many proofs in this Quran which also support Ar-Raj'a political Shia school of thought. What are they? There's ayah number two in the Quran. It's what we call Surah Al-Baqarah. Surah Al-Baqarah, the reason why the surah is called Surah Al-Baqarah is about Ar-Raj'a. How is it about Ar-Raj'a? It's about a man who reached and didn't have anybody to inherit him except his nephew, who was waiting and waiting for this uncle to die so he can inherit. And finally the uncle didn't die, so he decided to do what? To kill the uncle so he can inherit everything. He killed the uncle, he brought the body and dumped it on the middle of the road. And the same time he started screaming, somebody killed my uncle, somebody has murdered my uncle. Now Bani Israel, they came together to figure out how did that happen. Some believed in him and some had a doubt in him. Some said, no, he didn't kill. Some said, he did kill. How did he prove that? That is when Bani Israel went to Musa. Ya Musa, can you find a killer among Bani Israel who did murder this person? That is where the story of a cow came in the picture. Now, finally they found the cow. They killed it. What happened? Quran says, فَقُلْنَا ضَرِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا كَذَٰلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى. Allah said, took that piece of that meat, of that cow, and struck the disease. Allah said, he will come back alive. And that is how we, Allah, bring back the dead body. Surely enough, Musa alayhi salam, he told Bani Israel, they did that. And what happened? The man came back to life and he told Musa alayhi salam the murder and the reason behind it. And after that, now some narration says he lived some years afterwards. And that is the concept of Raja in the Shia school of thought. So some mufassirin, they said this Surah Al-Baqarah is another proof about a Raja in the Shia school of thought. That is number two. Number three. They said, not only that, when you come to the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about one of the great servants of Allah known as Uzair, who is also another example of Ar-Raja. You know, Uzair is one of the miracles of Allah. Uzair, they were twins, they were born. They were born on the same day. And they died on the same day, but one of them lived longer than the other because of the Raja'ah. Allahu Akbar. How did it happen? They were born the same day. They both died the same day, but one of them lived longer than the other. How? Uzair, who was the other brother, Quran says one day he was traveling. أَوَكَلَّذِي مَرَّ عَلَى قَرْيَةٍ وَهِيَ خَاوِيَةٌ عَلَى أُرُوشِهَا. He was traveling on his donkey and he passed by a town where everyone in that village is dead. قال, he says, Uzair, أَنَّا يُحْيِي اللَّهُ هَذِهِ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. How can Allah bring all of these individuals back to life after they died? And he was saying this in his heart. In his mind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard him and Allah told Malak al-Maut, take his life right there. Now, this is one of the very important lessons. Imam Zayd al-Abidin, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, has one of the dua where he talked to Allah. He said, Ya man ya'lamu ma fi al-damir as-samitin. Ya Allah, you are the one who knows what is hidden in the heart of those who are silent. They are not talking, but he knows what is in your mind. He knows what is in your heart, right? Now, Uzair, he didn't say it out loud. He said it in his mind and heart, but Allah heard him. Anna yuhyi Allah. How can Allah bring all of this back to life, right? Allah heard him. Allah told Malak al-Maut, take his life right there. And Allah took his life. Uzair, he died instantly among the those who were already dead. He was dead for how long? For many years. Then Allah told Malak al-Maut, give him his life back. He gave life back. Then Uzair came back to life. After he came back life, Allah asked Jibreel, go and ask him, kam labith? How long were you here? But now Uzair, in his mind, says, yawman aw ba'da yawm.
Allahu Akbar.
Now listen care, brothers and sisters. Quran reminds you, you and I, when Yawm al-Qiyamah happens, Allah said it will sound like it was like a half a day. كَأَنَّهُمْ لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا إِلَّا عَشِيَّةً أَوْ ضُحَاهَا. Allah said, this life that we have, 80 years, 100 years, 120, after we die, your day of resurrection, when we come up, the day that all these years that we live, it will sound like few hours. Right? Now the proof of it is Uzair. After he came back to life, Allah asked Jibreel to ask him, how long were you dead? قَالَ يَوْمًا. It's like a day. أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمًا. Maybe it's not even a day. That was his thinking, huh? Then Jibreel said to him, يَا أُزَيْر بَلْ لَبِثْتَ مِئَةُ عَام. You were dead here for 100 years. Uzair couldn't believe. It didn't sound like that long, right? To prove to him, Allah said to him, انظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسن. Allah said, look at our miracle, your food and your water. They didn't change, nothing changed. Allahu Akbar. Now, but turn and look at your donkey. وانظر إلى حمارك. But look at your donkey, and the donkey has turned to nothing but bones and dust after 100 years. Now look at the miracle of Allah between food and the donkey. Which do you think should survive longer? Huh? Now if you have a food, right? And you have a donkey, and you think, who will survive longer? In our mind, the donkey, right? Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made the food to survive for 100 years, but the donkey couldn't survive 100 years. You know the message? The message is one ayah. Wallahu ala kulli shay'in qadir. Then Allah wants to remind you and I that don't think of what you think is always the case. When it's come to me, Allah, nothing is impossible to me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a power over everything as He wishes. Uzair, Allah told him, now Uzair, we are not done with you. Now look at that donkey which is dead. انظر إلى حمارك انظر إلى حمارك كيف ننشزها ثم نكسوها لحما. I said, look, we're going to tell you, Uzair, you were wondering how Allah is going to bring all those people who are dead. Allah said, we will show you how we bring dead back to life in front of you as you watch. Ya Uzair, how is it going to happen? I said, Unzur, look, right? Because this is something we all wondering all the time. And Quran talks about it in Surah Yasin. Qalu kay, they said, those kuffar, when they came to Rasulullah with the bone of their father, how can Allah bring this dead body back to life after years and years of death? Qul yuhyiha alladhi ansha'aha awwala marra. Allah said, listen, the Lord who created it when there was nothing is the same Lord who will create it after it dies. Allah told Uzair, look, how is it going to happen? I said, Undur. Uzair was looking, and those scattered skeletons all over the place of that donkey started to come back together. In the matter of seconds, he saw skeleton of his donkey standing. As if Allah is telling Uzair, this is part one of the show. So you can see the skeleton, part one. Now what is the part two? Allah says, ثُمَّ نَكْسُوهَا لَحْمَا. Now if you look in Arabic, ثُمَّ بِمَعْنَى لِلْتَرْتِيبِ, meaning in order. Now we show you the skeleton. Now the second part is what? How are we gonna cover that skeleton with the flesh? Uzair is watching, and those dirt, turn to flesh, and each one of the part of that flesh knows where to go and when to go. In the matter of second, they saw also the flesh is covered that skeleton. Allah said, now Uzair, we're not even done yet. Now look, how are we gonna send the ruh into that body and see how that donkey will come back to life as it used to be before we took life. Uzair was looking in the matter of seconds, Then the donkey started moving, walked to Uzair, and Uzair could see everything he knows about that donkey is in that donkey. The same thing like Allah tells you and I in the Quran, in Surah Al-Qiyamah, أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَلَّا النَّجْمَ عِظَامَ بَلَا قَادِرِينَ عَلَىٰ أَن نُسَوِّيَ بَنَانَ. Allah said, do people think we're not going to be able to gather all those bones after he dies? Allah said, we will bring the bones together. Not only the bones, Allah said, your thumbprint also will come back to you as it was in this world before you died. That after that, Uzair looked at it and Uzair said, what? He said, أَعْلَمُ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. I said, now I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a power over everything. That is another proof in Quran that Raja'a, the way she, I believe, does exist. Now, not only that, another proof from the Quran is Isa ibn Maryam. Now, we all know in Surah Maryam, Allah told us about Isa, that Allah gave him miracles. One of the miracles of Isa, وَتُحْيَ الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِي. You bring dead back to life with the permission of Allah. Isa alayhi salam, many people died. Isa didn't know when they died, but Isa was able to bring them back to life and have them live for another years after they died, many years. And one of the very famous story of Isa alayhi salam is when Isa was traveling in a town and he heard a woman who had one son and that son died. And she was crying as if she is also about to die. Isa alayhi salam heard about it. He asked, they told him, Ya Isa ibn Maryam, Innaha imra'atun thakla. In Arabic, thakla, al-thaqil, is a woman who lost her son and only son. I said, where is she? They took Isa to that house. Isa went to her. He gave her his condolences. And he asked her, do you want your son to come back? She said, of course. If there is any way I can have my son back, of course I want it. Isa alayhi salam, I said, can we go to the grave? Show me where your son is buried. She said, yes. They took Isa alayhi salam to the grave. They dug the grave. They found the body was still in there. Isa alayhi salam called the young man. When he called the young man, he opened his eyes. He told him, oh young man, would you like to come back to this life? He said, no, I don't want to. Why didn't you want to come? He said, I am happy in that world. I'm not willing to come back to the world which is filled of struggle and trouble and problems. I don't want to come. Then Isa said to him, what if you coming back will cause your mother's happiness? If you come back, your mother will be happy. If you stay there, it's your own happiness. Which one would you like to choose? He said, Ya Isa, I will come back to make my mother happy. Isa alayhi salam, he asked him to come out of the grave. He came out, he lived after that for many years before he died. This is the concept of Raja'a in the Shia school of thought as we speak. And that is one of the ayah in the Quran, وَتُحْيَ الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِي. You give a life to the dead with the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, not only that, in the Quran, another ayah Allah talks about it is about Ibrahim alayhi salam, which is mentioned next to the ayah about Uzair, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim has a habit every morning after his Fajr prayer, he will go to the river to see the animals into the sea or into the ocean. Until one day he got there and he saw a dead animal. Half of it was in the sea and the other half on the land. And that one dead animal, there are animals in the sea who are eating the dead animal, and the ones on the land, they also eat it. Ibrahim alayhi salam started to wonder, Ya Rabbi, one dead animal, his meat is being distributed among those dead and those living animals on the land and some in the sea. Ya Rab, how are you gonna gather all these pieces from all of these 1, 2, 3 animals on the land and the others in the sea to bring this dead animal Yawm al-Qiyam? Because you know, as we believe, Allah will bring all animals Yawm al-Qiyamah too. وإذا الوحوش حشرت. All animals will be brought يوم القيامة. Ibrahim was wondering. Allah told him, Ya Ibrahim, أولم تؤمن. Don't you believe that your Lord has a power to do all of that? He said, Bala, I believe. Allahu Akbar. I said, you believe? He said, yes. ولكن ليطمئن قلبي. Ya Allah, but I want something for my own comfort of heart. I want to see something so my iman can increase. Allah told him, Ya Ibrahim, find 4 different type of birds. Slaughter them. Then mix their meat. Then put meat on 4 of these different mountains. And then you, Ibrahim, stand on separate mountain and then call them and see if they will respond or not. Ibrahim alayhi salam find those 4 birds, slaughter them, mix the meat as he was told, and put on 4 different mountains. Then Allah said, ثُمَّ دُؤُهُنَّ يَأْتِينَكَ سَعْيًا. Allah said, Ya Ibrahim, when you put the meat, you stand on separate mountain and then you call them. Allah said, they will come to you, running to you to respond to the call that you call. Ibrahim did that when he stood on the mountain. He called, Ya ayyatuha tuyur, oh you birds, come towards me. Ibrahim was standing. Then the meat started to fly on the mountain number 1 to the mountain number 4. Some from the mountain number 4 to number 2. Some from 2 to 3. They meet each other and form the same birds as they were before Ibrahim slaughtered them. Then Ibrahim saw them running to him, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him. Then Allah said to him, Ya Ibrahim, this is what I call wa al-bath wal-nushur. This is how I will bring that back to life. That is another proof of what we call al-raj'ah. Now, al-dalil al-aqli from the Shia school of thought, why do we believe this is going to happen? We believe that al-raj'ah is nothing but to prove the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's number 1. And number 2, al-raja'a is to confirm what we call yawm al-qiyamah. Because many of you, we believe there's a qiyamah, but we have a doubt. How could that be possible? Will it happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put all of these examples so that we can see it practical, so that you and I will not doubt the power of Allah yawm al-qiyamah. And that is the summary about what we call al-raja'a. And you know, al-raja'a is also has everything to do with Habib ibn Mudahir. Habib, one of the companions of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, he is the symbol of raja'a. You know, in one narration, there was a time Habib ibn Mudahir fell and died. It's way before Karbala. When he died, his father rushed to Imam Ali alayhi salam, and he told Imam Ali about Habib. He said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, this happened to Habib. Can you help? They rush with Imam Hussein alayhi salam. When they got there, Habib was already dead. Then Imam alayhi salam told Imam Hussein, Ya Hussein, do something for Habib. Habib, do something. Imam Hussein alayhi salam, he looked at Habib, he read something in his ear, he wiped on his face, and Habib came back to life after his death. And this is exactly hadith that we read, Ziyarat Warith, As-salamu alayka ya waritha Isa, Ruh. After that, when Imam Hussein alayhi salam was going to Karbala, he sent a letter to Habib ibn Mudahir. Habib didn't know where Imam Hussein had been for so many years. He was sitting in the morning to eat his breakfast. A message came to the door. Habib opened the door. He saw the letter. He opened the letter and he started to read it. On the table where his wife and his son were sitting to have breakfast. When he finished reading that letter of Imam Hussein, he kissed it. He kissed the letter of Imam Hussein. When he kissed it, He started crying. His wife asked him, Ya Habib, why are you crying? He says, My beloved Abba Abdullah has sent me a letter inviting me to join him in Karbala. And I have to join him in Karbala. His wife, she said to him, Ya Habib, Hussein has been your very old friend from the childhood. Ya Habib, honor the call of your brother and your Imam Abba Abdullah Hussein. But you know, the letter came to Habib ibn Mudahir at the time where Kufa is locked, blocked all over the place. Nobody can get out. Nobody can come into Kufa. But Habib has to go to Iraq. He has to go to Karbala. So what did he do? Habib told his slave, he said, take my horse and get it out of Kufa and I will find a way to join you and meet you at my farm and take the horse from there. Habib, he told his slave, the slave took the horse, he went out, he was waiting Habib but will come since in the morning. Habib didn't come until almost Asr time. The slave didn't see Habib show up. He started to talk to the horse. He said, oh you horse, my master Habib wants to mount on you and go to support the grandson of Rasulullah. But he is delayed for some reason. I swear by Allah, if my master Habib didn't come, I will mount on you to go and help the grandson of Rasulullah. As he was speaking to the horse, Habib showed up. Habib told his slave, thank you for the wait. Please go, and you are now free from the face of earth. You are no longer a slave of me. You can go anywhere you want to go. Allahu Akbar. Look at the slave of Habib. He says to Habib, Ya Habib, you are not fair to me. Habib said, what are you talking about? I said, Ya Habib, I've served you all these years as a slave to you. And now you decided to go and serve Imam Hussein. And you are depriving me the honor to go and serve Abba Abdullah. Allahu Akbar. Habib ibn Mudahir looked at his slave and he said to him, do you want to come to Karbala with me? He said, yes, indeed, I want to come to Karbala. He said, sit on this horse with me. He took with him his slave to Karbala. Habib ibn Mudahir reached Karbala on the night of Ashura. When Imam Hussein was not even expecting Habib, all of a sudden Habib showed up. Imam Hussein saw them, and Imam Hussein had a joy and tears on his face for seeing a man like Habib. As he walks towards the companions of Imam Hussein, Zainab salamullahi alayha, she heard him. She said, Assalamu alayka ya Habib ibn Mudahir al-Asadi. You know, when Habib heard salam of Zainab, he took his turban and threw it away. He then tore his shirt and he says, Tabban lakum ya a'da Allah. May the wrath of Allah be upon you, the enemies of Allah. Do you dare to bring the daughter of Rasulullah and put her in the plain land of Karbala in a place like this? Habib was so angry to see Zainab salamullahi alayha and those children in that tent. Until the day of Ashura, Habib ibn Mudahir, he was with Imam Hussein alayhi salam when the companions were going one after the other, until Habib asked Imam Hussein alayhi salam, Ya Abba Abdullah, allow me to go to the battlefield. Give me the honor of Shahada. Imam Hussein looked at him. He says, Ya Habib, you are a very elderly man. And whenever I see you, I have some courage. Whenever I look at you, I have the honor of looking at you. Ya Habib, stay with me. Habib listened to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. until finally Habib said to Imam Hussein alayhi salam, I've seen your enemies are more and your loved ones are few. Ya Aba Abdullah, give me the honor to go to the battlefield. Imam Hussein alayhi salam allowed him. Habib went to the battlefield. He fought, even though he's very aged, even though he's an elderly, he fought and fought. According to some of the scholars, Habib ibn Mudahir was able to kill almost 72 men of the enemies of Islam on the day of Ashura. Finally, the enemies attack Habib ibn Mudahir. They attack him from by a man called Hasin La'natullahi alayhi. He attack Habib ibn Mudahir. He attack him by striking his sword on the shoulder of Habib. Habib fell on the ground. He tried to stood up. Another one called Tamimi came. He struck Habib on the head. Habib fell on the ground as he was in his final moment. Habib alayhi salam was there, and then the enemy came as he was about to kill Habib. Habib alayhi salam, he finally was killed, and they cut his head. Habib was the first shaheed among all the shuhada of Karbala to be killed and then cut his head. When they cut the head of Habib ibn Mudahir, they didn't put his head on the spears like they did with the rest of the shuhada. They carry his head and they tie the rope on with his head and wrap on the head and the neck of one of the horses. Habib had a son called Qasim. His son was looking at his father's head, trying to follow Al-Hasin to get the head from him. He would not give the head to him. Finally, Hasin looked at him. He said, why are you following him everywhere I go? He said, I want my father's head to bury. That's my father. You killed him, that is one crime. Give the father my father's head to go bury it. But some of the poet says, as the head of Habib, as if it was responding, oh my son Qasim, you are asking my head to be given for you to go buried? What about the head of Aba Abdullah, which was put on the spears, which was carried from one city to another city, which was taken from the one city to another, from one country to another? Inna lillah. وإنا إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين. يا حسين 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 حسين
حسين حسين Hussein, 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 Hussein,
Hussein, Hussein, تین روز سے کن با رسول کا اے نہر القما اے نہر القما اے نہر القما کچھ تجھ سے دور پیاسوں کا کارواں اے نہر القما اے
نہر القما
اللہ رے وفا اے علم دار کربلا کیا فرات پہ پانی نہیں پیا اے
ہے حسرت سے دیکھتے رہے بچے سوئے فرات صاف کا اہل بیت نہ خیمے تکا سکا اے نہر القمر کے واسطے کرتی رہی دعا اصغر سے نونہال کو پانی نہیں ملا
ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی ہمیں کرب و بلا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی کفن کے ساتھ رکھ دینا لحد میں کفن کے ساتھ رکھ دینا لحد میں مجھے خاک شفا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی میں دنیا سے چلا جاؤں گا لیکن میں دنیا سے چلا جاؤں گا لیکن مجھے شہر کی عزا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم صدا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا زندہ رکھے گی علم کے سائے میں آ جا تو تجھ کو علم کے سائے میں آ جا کے تجھ کو پھرے کی ہوا زندہ رکھے گی یہ ماتم کی صدا رکھے گی
اللهم صل على